you need to remove a background of an image but don't know how to do that, I have a couple different videos on how to do that for different tools. You can check out one here on Photo Clipping, which is a free browser tool that you can use. Or if you have access to Photoshop, there is a quick and easy way to be able to do this and fine tune it. And I'm going to walk you through how to do that today. All right, welcome back. If you haven't checked out my website already, go ahead and check out my website, which is learningdojo.ninja. Here you can check out previous tutorials on my blog. You can also download templates on Articulate Storyline, XAPI templates, and video templates as well. And you can find full courses on Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 Video. Today we're going to be talking about how to remove a background and actually how to blur a background easily inside of Photoshop. Now I'm going to be using Photoshop 2022. You can also do this with Photoshop 2021 if you have access to that or access to the Creative Cloud here. Now I'm also going to be using images from pexels.com. So I've downloaded two images. I've downloaded this one where I want to remove the background, and you can see who's actually uploaded that so you can give them credits inside of your e-learning course if you're going to be using that. And then also I'm going to blur the background here with this image, which is the same person that took this image. And so I'm going to blur out the background, and we're going to talk about two quick ways to be able to do that. So if you go into pexels.com and you want to follow along with the same images, go ahead and just type in person, and you should be able to scroll down and find these two images right here. I'm going to close out this other tab here, and those images are already downloaded on my desktop here. So you can see right here these two images. We're going to start out with this first one, and we're going to remove the background so we can put our own background in or use that inside of an e-learning course with some, if the person was pointing or something like that, you can use that similar to how you work with inside of people pictures inside of Storyline. So if you want to just additional ones, or if you have your own images, this is a great way to be able to cut those out easily. I'm going to go ahead and just drag that and open this up inside of Photoshop, which if you're on a Mac, you can just click and drag to the icon and it will open up, or you can just open up Photoshop, go to File, Open, and find your image here. Now to do this, the first thing that we need to do is unlock the layer that we're working with inside of Photoshop. So I'm going to come down to here and I'm going to unlock that layer here. Now I need to have the Properties panel open at this time. If you don't have your Properties panel open, you can just go ahead and go into Window up on top here and go down to Properties and make sure that it's there. Now with that open and with the base layer selected, if you don't have it selected, you won't see these options. Make sure that you go down to the properties and there's these quick actions down at the bottom. Now these quick actions will change based on what you actually have selected. And the first thing that I have here is remove background. So you can see that it automatically removes the background and it does a really good job. You can see here, it even kind of kept track of that cup and everything. So there's not much that I need to do here, but there is some things that I could clean up, like around her hair here. And you can fine tune this a little bit more if you go up to select and then you go down to select and mask. If you go to select and mask, you have a couple different things that you can play around with. You can see here the transparency. If I adjust this, it will bring that background back. And so I can go ahead and see what that background is. And sometimes I like to do that a little bit as I'm deselecting or selecting different elements here, just so I can see what the background was and what's been selected and hasn't been. I'm going to just put that at about 56% here. And now I'm going to come over to this quick select tool, and we can either bring back, if I click on this plus icon, I can bring back some of the background image, or let me do Command Z or Control Z. I'm going to go back into this quick select tool, and I'm going to go ahead and minus. Now this will get rid of some of those, and I can also adjust the size of the brush as well. I'm also going to click on Control plus and minus to zoom in, and I want to clean this up a little bit. I'm just going to scroll this and kind of match this, and sometimes it'll jump like that, which is okay. It's just selecting some of that area there. I'm going to make sure that this part kind of out here is selected. Oop, did a little too much. So I'm going to do Control Z here, parts being a little bit tricky here. Or we can just do brush. Instead of it being trying to select everything, I can use the brush tool to get a little bit more fine-tuned. which is also nice with the brush tool because I can adjust the hardness and if I want it to be less hard here. And so it's a little bit more feathered. It doesn't have kind of those harsh edges there. I think that's looking a little bit better with the brush tool. Get rid of that part right here. There we go. So I'm going to zoom back out and let's up the transparency back to 100 here. And that's cleaned up her hair a little bit. Now you may not have to do this for every single image, but if you needed to clean up a certain area with some of the images, you can do that. You can also adjust some kind of global settings for like the smoothness, feather as well, if that works. But I'm going to click OK for now. And there we go. We have our image. I can go ahead and click on File and Save As. And then I'm going to click on Don't Show Again here. I'm going to save it on my computer. And now I can go ahead and save this as a PNG. Click OK, Save. And if I come back into here, there we have that image that's kind of cropped out there and I can insert inside of Storyline or Captivate. So I now have cut out that image and it's good to go. What about blurring the background? If I wanted to take a person that's standing there and I don't want the background to be as visible, you can do that as well. So I'm going to open this up inside of Photoshop and I'm going to go ahead and do the same thing that I did before. I need to unlock this image first of all. I'm going to unlock it and then I'm going to go make sure that properties is pulled open and make sure that this is selected. Now we still have the options to remove the background or to select the subject, whoever the person is. But there are more quick actions here. There is blur background, select subject, smooth skin, adjust lighting as well. I want to blur the background and it's going to take a second, but you can see here that now it's blurred this background. Now you can see right here, refine with select and mask or refine with Gaussian blur. I'm going to go ahead and click exit there and we're going to go up to select and we're going to go to select and mask. So now I can do the same thing that I was doing before. I can go ahead and just either under the plus icon, let's zoom in on different parts and just make sure that nowhere is he actually blurred. And I could just probably fix that so it's not as blurred here. But for the most part, this is actually looking really good. So I don't need to do too much here with this image, but you may need to remove some of the blur or add some of the blur in this area, similar to what we did with removing the background. So now I can go ahead and click OK. And I can save this and there we go. And that's great if you took like a couple different images with like an office in the background and you want the office to be a little bit blurred, you can do that as well. You can also come in here to the Gaussian blur and if you click on that, you can adjust how blurry that is. If you go up or if you go down, it will adjust what, you know, if it's really blurry or not so blurry, you can do that as well. So those are a couple different options to remove the background and to blur the background in your images. And then to save those, you just always go to File, Export, Export as PNG, or Save As, and you can save it there. Hopefully that's helpful for you. If you wanted to check out more tutorials, make sure that you like and subscribe to this video. And comment below, let me know if there's other types of design tips and tricks that you want to see for making your e-learning courses better. If you also wanted to check out my website, go ahead and check out learningdojo.ninja. Here you can check out my blog posts with previous tutorials. You can check out templates, but you can also check out full courses A to Z with hands-on examples of Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Custom Squirm, and HTML5 Video. Hopefully you've liked this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks, everyone.